how you doing? My name is Andre+Cato and today I am here with the new SCS4DJ. Now, while it is not a brand new product, it does have a brand new version 2 of the firmware, and this has opened up the doorway to an even greater experience with the SCS4DJ. So look, I wanted to run through things with you today and just have a look at the machine, how it works, who it's for, and what all the different functions are. So, Stanton have been around since about 1948, creating phono cartridges for turntables. And earlier this millennium, they created the first digital hybrid system with native instruments in Final Scratch, and so they really do have quite a long history in the digital DJ environment. But what they've created with the 4DJ is a hybrid unit that doesn't require you to plug in a computer. This unit has everything in it. It's got the computer inside it, it's got the screen. And the screen is actually a 4.3-inch high-resolution LCD, making it an unbelievably bright and cool experience as a DJ performing on it. It's a great stepping stone for a beginner, because if you are a beginner, obviously price is going to be important. And as you can see from what's on my screen here, it's just been given the DJ Tech Awards for the best controller under £600. And it's actually considerably less than that. So it really is a fantastic unit. As I mentioned, I do love the screen on it, but it's not just the screen that makes it so cool. So what I want to do today is run through some of these features and work out what it is about the SCS4DJ that makes it such a great tool for beginners, mobile DJs, dudettes that want to DJ at home, or simply get into the art form of digital mixing. So, first of all, what is it? Well, basically, it's a two-deck DJ control system. We have a mixer here in the middle with a beautiful screen, as mentioned. We have two control surfaces with effects, transport control, and your normal pitch controls. But it also has some of these digital controls, such as your sync buttons. It has eight, what they call soft buttons, up on the screen. So basically, depending on which menu system out of the four along here you're in, these eight buttons will change what they do, so you can get around the menu system and configure it and load things to playlists and basically get it working the way that you want it to work. Now, one of the things that I absolutely adore about this machine is the way that you can plug into it. It is a USB driven machine, so we have USB port on the top here, we have a couple at the back, and most importantly and most joyously, we have two in under the unit. Now, the two under the unit are unbelievable because they lock away underneath the base plate, and it means you can put full-size laptop hard drives under there and store them away, keep them as part of the unit, basically pick up this whole unit, take that to work, sit it down on your console, plug it in, and you're ready to go. The only disadvantage with all of that hard drive space is, and it's something that, you know, a lot of people have been discussing online in the last 6 months, is the time that it takes to read all of your music. Now, look, this is a job that the machine has to do when you first get the machine and set it up with your music library. And it does take a little while for all of this to happen. So it's a great thing for you to set up for it to happen overnight or over, you know, a couple of days in some instances, if you've got weeks and weeks and weeks worth of music on your hard drives that you're trying to have read and loaded and organized by the SCS4DJ. Basically, for every track that the SCS4DJ has on any one of the drives, it works out the speed, where to place beat markers, and also to create a coloured waveform for it. So all of these things do take time, but once you've done that, you never have to do it again. And so it's really not an issue. The other really, really great thing that they've added with the version 2 software is if you put in a stick and you've got some new tunes and you want to try them out straight away, what you can now do is put the stick in and load the track to any either of the deck A or deck B, and it will instantly analyze that track and put that to the top of the list and analyze it immediately, so you're ready to play that track within, you know, a minute or so, as opposed to having to wait for the entire library to be read. So that is fantastic. Okay, so if you just come in a little closer, we're going to have a look at all the different controls on here, how they work and what they actually do. Let's have a very, very quick look at what's on the front and back panels. We have our mic input with our mic volume and the master volume. And if we swing over this way, we have the volume of the headphones in the middle, the mix of the headphones from, you know, what you're listening to out of the master output and the headphone output, and inputs for either your standard quarter or an eighth inch jack headphones, which is very, very handy. So that's on the front. And if we flip the unit around, you have a Kensington lock here, the master outputs, which are balanced outputs. We have RCA outputs. We have the USB in and out. So that is where you will store another hard drive for more music, and that one is so you can control things such as tractor and power and a power switch. Starting down here, we have the transport controls. So we have play, we have cue, we have the sync button and the tap. We have the button to activate the scratch. That is very, very cool. As mentioned earlier, these jog dials are awesome and feel fantastic. The resolution is really, really, really good. We can also set it up so when we are playing, we can automatically jump back to the cue point every time we touch the top of the unit, like this. Very handy for people that want to do beat juggling tricks. As we move up, we have pitch bend and a pitch controller. Here, we have loop controls. We can set up a loop and we can halve that loop, double the length of the loop to whatever size loop we would like within that beat grid, which is fantastic. And straight above that, we have these four effects, which we'll have a quick listen to when I do a very, very quick mix at the end of this. To control the rate and the timing and the frequency and amount of effects, we have these two pots straight above it, which work very, very well. We can change the beat and obviously, you know, the amount of the effect that we want to include. So that there is obviously duplicated down on this side as well. We have a crossfader, and one of my favorite functions on this unit is the record mode. What I've found to be the best way to record is to format your drive in FAT32. Now, I use a drive specifically for recording. If you do that, you will find that you won't have any screen lag or any other issues that may occur by trying to not only play back but record at the same time. These are the soft buttons that we talked about earlier, so four on either side of the screen. Here's the lovely 4.3 inch screen, and here is the four menu buttons. So in the home and waveform, we can see if you've got any artwork for the album cover. You can see a small version of the waveform. If we go back here, we can zoom out or in. We can add things directly to playlists as we're going. So we can jump in here, search for whatever we want, add it to the current playlist, or we can go into playlist and it will show us what we've been playing recently. Jump into the playlist menu and it'll show you all your playlists. And of course, the system menu will allow us to set up the unit the way that we like. So this is great because we can set up the unit as a MIDI controller. There is now a four deck TSI for the SCS DJ, and that's really, really cool. Also in here, we have a video player. The video player, when you get the unit, automatically will have a demonstration of the unit, which is really, really handy for those beginners. But you can also load your own AVI files so that when you're finished practicing, you can sit there in bed and watch movies of any description, really. Well, yes, any description. And above that, we have the devices so we can see what we have plugged in. Display settings, so you can set up whether you have time remaining or time that you've played, and all the different things to do with the display. The actual unit settings, crossfader settings. So this is great for scratchers that want to be able to do really tidy and tight controlled crossfade tricks. You can set it up either with a really nice long blend, or you can set it up so it has a very, very tight blend. So it really does cater for all different styles of DJing. You can also set up things with the platter. So you've got startup speed and slow down speed, so you can have really cool breaking effects. And you also have an audio settings menu, which will set up things like the auto cue, the loop length when you automatically press this loop button, and the mic boost. Let's have a listen to some mixing to see what the record output sounds like, and also, you know, what kind of result we get. First things first, let's hit the record button. We can select a drive. I'm going to use my drive, that one of my drives that's in underneath the unit. And so I'm going to select that. So let's have a listen. So that's the SCS4DJ. As I mentioned before, it is available now. It's been available for some time, but now it is available with the version 2 software and all of the updates that we've just been discussing. So do go online, check out those updates and see what you think. But trust me, this is an awesome unit for beginners, mobile DJs, DJs that want to play at home, or DJs looking for a crossover product to introduce them into the realm of digital software mixing while still having a hardware control device that you don't need to have lots of computer knowledge and have to plug things in and work out how to map things to this or that or the other. Hope you've enjoyed this review. My name is Andre+Cato and I will see you very, very soon.